Hi again, and now I'm in my room in Istanbul, and I'm so happy to be in here after like a month or 3 weeks, I don't know. I feel way more comfortable in here, but I was so happy with my father and brother also. But I don't know, it's my home. I don't feel like at home while I'm in Aydın, so I'm so happy to be in here again. I came here just so sudden, let's say. Actually, I had to come here because I had some job interviews in here, so I came here. I couldn't record any videos after uploading my second video because I was like going to my summer house and then come back to my hometown. And it was all the same things, and I was just reading book, and that was all. I couldn't study any English, and I didn't have any motivation at all. I didn't think that I will be so unmotivated about doing some stuff, but like I was only reading, and it was so hard for me to even reading something. My only motivation was meeting my friends, and that was all, I guess. We were just doing the same stuff every single day. And it was so hot in Aydın. It was like 42 degrees and I wasn't able to go outside to meet my friends before like 7 or 8 o'clock. So yeah, it was kind of boring for me. So I'm so, again I'm saying, I'm so happy to be here. I will talk about what have I done when I was in Aydın and when I didn't record any video. I told you that I will write it down, the important dates for me, and this is the notebook that I have to write something. And I want to share the fourth one that I experienced while I was in Aydın, and it was so exciting moment for me. Whew. Okay, I'm starting. The date is 10th of July. Me and my father was in Kuşadası and we decided to go to beach at night, and I told my father that there is a place where people sing and have fun. I mean, there was a place and singers were singing. But that night, there were no singers, there were just a guy who plays saxophone. We were just sitting there and listening to music and chit-chatting. Then a boy, let's say, started to sing a song, and it was so clear that he wasn't a professional singer or something. He was just a random guy and he was singing. It was fun. He was good. And then people start to go on the stage and singing some songs, and it became so funny because there were like children and they were singing and we were having just fun. We were laughing at them and we started to think that I can sing too. So I always wanted to sing a song on the stage, and that was the opportunity. I was so excited and I wasn't sure if I can make it, but my father has encouraged me a lot, and I realized that I didn't even remember the people who sang on the stage, and I was just having fun and they were having fun, so I thought that I can sing too. So I decided the song I will sing, and I get on the stage, let's say, and sang. So I want to share it with you guys, and I want it to be stay forever in my channel. Okay, let's just see the video.
So tell me to leave, I'll pack my bags, get on the road. Find someone that loves you better than I do, darling, I know. 'Cause you remind me every day. If you want me to leave, then tell me to leave, and baby, I'll go. enough, but I still stay.
That was the video. I want to tell you why it was so important for me. Here is the story. When I was in middle school, I had a teacher who admired my voice a lot, like not my voice, the tone of my voice. And he always told me that I should be a presenter. One day, I will tell this story to make everything more clear. One day I came to school and there was a celebration in school and I was like, okay, let's go to school. And my teacher saw me and he was like, Talu, come here, come here. And I was like, oh my God, what did I do? And I knew that I didn't do anything. I was just like thinking. He told me that I will be presenter of the day. And I was like shocked and I said that, no, I can't. I really can't. I'm so scared of being on the stage. And he was like, no, you can do this and you will do this. And I couldn't reject, but I was so shaking. He just gave me the script and I wasn't even prepared for being on the stage. And I got on the stage that day. I was like so shaking. My face was turning on white. My friends came to me after the celebration or everything and told me that you were so white and you were so shaky that we thought that you will faint and we were so ready to hold you if you like faint or something. But the point is, I have this big fear of being on the stage. It's like a phobia or something, I don't know. I got so shaky and I got so excited. So yeah, that's why I was so like nervous about on the stage and also singing on the stage. I thought that today I will do this and I have no longer have that phobia because I will see that there will be no people who will make fun of me. It will be a memory for you and for your children or your... You can watch this memory with your friends and forget everyone. It will be an opportunity for you to make something for yourself. And I was thinking that way. It will be a memory for me and I will not forget it for the rest of my life. And I did it. I'm so happy that I did it. And I had fun. My father had fun. And I'm pretty sure that I made mistakes on the stage. I was again shaking and people saw it. Maybe they smiled or laughed. But it doesn't matter. Everybody had fun. And they don't remember me right now. Maybe they told that there was a girl there and she sang. She was horrible. She didn't have a good voice, but she was there. But then that's over. They didn't think about me again and they will not. But I will not forget that moment for the rest of my life. Everybody will forget you, but you will not forget the memories you have. So if you want to do something, do it for yourself, not for anyone else. So I'm so happy that I did it and I just wanted to share it with you guys. You know, I always say that I will get out of my comfort zone. I know that you are hearing so many comfort zone in my videos, but I guess it's our channel's thing.